Today we are going to discuss in business policy Michael Porter's generic business strategies. Now to understand the Michael Porter's business generic business strategies, first of all let us see how the Michael Porter contributes at Harvard Business School. Now Michael Porter leads the Institute for Strategy and Competitiveness. Okay, now what the Michael Porter has to say about competition. Now Michael Porter says that it is competitive advantage is ultimately won or lost at the industry level. Okay, and the basic unit of analysis is competition is industry. So what is industry? Industry is basically a group of competitors. A group of competitors are there who are competing with each other and who are having almost similar products and services. Are having almost similar products and services and they are competing with each other. That's what the concept of industry is. Now they are producing almost similar type of product and services at comparable prices and competing with each other. Now I will tell you that what is the industry structure. Now industry structure is decided by the five forces. Now Michael Porter's five forces that decide the industry structure are following. The first one is the threat of new entrant. Then second one is the threat of substitute products. Third one is the bargaining power of suppliers. Fourth one is bargaining power of buyers. And fifth one is the rivalry among the existing competitors. So these are the different five different forces which shape the competition in an industry. So this is the five forces which shape the industry structure. Fine, this is one thing. Now each of the industry is having its unique structure. Each of the industry is having its unique structure and that determines the profitability of the companies operating in that industry. So that is the first aspect, which is the industry structure. Fine, we will take the second one, positioning of firm in industry. Now when we talk about positioning of firm in an industry, then we are talking about the overall approach of competing in that industry. How a particular company competes in a particular industry. Overall approach, that's what the positioning aspect is. Now we will discuss here one important aspect, that is competitive advantage and competitive scope. Now competitive advantage, basically a particular company operating in an industry is having a particular strategy. Is having a particular strategy that particular company can produce a particular product, that is the product which is produced through mass production, and then mass marketing is done, mass distributed through the mass marketing, and then customer satisfaction takes place. So one type of strategy, one approach of positioning is that the company is producing the mass marketing group products and services distributed through the mass marketing, and then that produces the customer satisfaction. So this is one way. Or second way is that a particular company produces product or services that is highly specialized product or services. That is highly specialized product or services targeting a specific group of customers. That is targeting a specific group of customers, highly focused and identified group of customers, and then what happens? That these particular group of people are willing to pay premium price for the product. Now high price products are there. The products which are produced and marketed are high price products, and the customers are highly focused group of customers who are willing to pay premium to the supplier who is going to fulfill the needs and wants of that particular group of customers. So this is the second approach of positioning. So the first approach of positioning and second approach of positioning is there. Fine, this is one thing. After this we will come to the competitive advantage. Now competitive advantage is basically, now Michael Porter has said that ultimately it is the industry level where the competitive advantage is ultimately won or lost. The competitive advantage is ultimately won or lost is at the industry level. Now The competitive advantage, there are two sources of competitive advantage. One is the low cost and second one is differentiation. One is the low cost, another one is differentiation. Now, the companies produced low cost product and services. The companies produced low cost product and services to compete in the marketplace. And second one is the differentiation. The company produces product and services and they differentiate their product and services from their rival companies. From their rival companies who are having similar product or offerings, they differentiate themselves from the competitors. How they differentiate their products from competitors? Now they differentiate their product and services from the competitors' product and services by offering extra value, by offering a special value, unique value. That not only unique value like after sales service is there, unique value is there, feature and attribute packed product and services are there, and this way they are differentiating their product from the product and services of their competitors. This is one thing. So this is what the competitive advantage is. Now after that, the next one is competitive scope. Now when we talk about competitive scope, then we talk about basically the breadth of the organization's target. Now let us understand what we precisely understand by the breadth of the organization's target. Now the breadth of the organization target is all about like the range of product and services the company is offering. The range of product and services which the company is offering, one thing. Second thing is that the group of customers the company is targeting. The group of customers the company is targeting, that is important. Apart from that, the third one is the channel of distribution employed. And fourth one is the geographical area. That if that geographical area is a widely scattered geographical area or narrowly defined geographical area. So that is all about the breadth of the organization's target is. This is the breadth of the organization's target. Now we will take up, now if you see this matrix here, we are having narrow target and we are having broad target. Now what is narrow target and what is broad target? Now narrowly targeting, the company produces limited range of product and services. The company produces the limited range of product and services and that is distributed through the channel of distribution. And targeting a broad range of customers. And that too, they are scattered across a wide geographical area. Those customers are scattered across a wide geographical area. So that is what is called as the broad target. So broad target is what? That is a particular group of customers are there. A particular range of product and services are there, which is full range of product and services catering to the requirements of broadly defined wide range of product and services catering to the requirements of wide range of customers, and that too using a channel of distribution, and those customers are scattered over a wide geographical area. Broad target is there. Narrow target, that is the companies is producing product and services which are of limited range, and then that is limited range of product and services are distributed through a channel of distribution targeting a small group of customers, and that too in a limited or confined geographical area, scattered geographical area. So this is the breadth of the organization's target in terms of the narrow target and broad target. Now I will tell you that the source of competitive advantage is low cost and differentiation. It is quite clear from this matrix. The source of competitive advantage is low cost and differentiation. So differentiation and low cost, we plot it on the x-axis. And second one is competitive scope. So competitive scope is of two types, narrow target and broad target. Now, when competitive advantage and competitive scope are juxtaposed,
when the competitive advantage and the competitive scope are juxtaposed, that is placed side by side, then we get a matrix of this type. Then we get the matrix of this type, and then this results in the three types of Michael Porter's generic business strategies. Now, what are those? The first one is the cost leadership strategy, and it is quite clear. That is, low cost product and services and broad target is there. Then that is, that matrix, that quadrant is called as cost leadership strategy. Then we are having broad target and differentiated product or service. Then differentiation strategy is there. And third one is the focus strategy. So we are having three Michael Porter's, three generic strategies, generic business strategies. That is, the first one is cost leadership strategies, second one is differentiation strategy, and third one is the focus strategy. Now there are two variants of focus strategy. The first one is called the focused cost leadership, and the second one is called as the focus differentiation. The focus differentiation is. So these are the three types of Michael Porter's generic business strategies. Fine, this is one thing. Now we will come to the first one, that is the cost leadership strategy. Now what is cost leadership strategies? Now I will tell you that basically organizations compete with each other, and when the organizations compete with each other, all of them try to produce the product which is low cost product. So what happens that the companies are producing product and services and they are producing low cost product, then in that industry a particular company which is producing the lower cost, which is having lower cost than other competitors, is having competitive advantage. And this all depends upon the efficiency of the company. It all depends upon the efficiency of the company to produce the product, design the product, and market the product efficiently, more efficiently rather than their competitors. If it is marketing, designing, producing and marketing the products more efficiently than its competitors, then the company's cost structure is low and the company gets the competitive advantage in that industry. So that becomes one important aspect. Fine, after this I will tell you that, you know, when the company tries to achieve cost leadership, then we have to understand the concept of the value chain. Now, the cost is spread across the entire value chain. The cost of product is spread over the entire value chain. Entire value chain of what? Right from raw material stage to selling of the product or service. The entire value chain is there. And different activities are there in the value chain. We are having different activities in the value chain. So what happens? That the company tries to squeeze cost. At each of the stages or all the activities which are contributing to the production of the product. The company tries to reduce the cost in each of them. Try to squeeze the every paisa out of the each of the activities. So that becomes important here across the value chain. Now I'll tell you, so many companies are there, so many value chain is there. So the company which achieves the more efficiently able to squeeze the cost, the total cost of the product across the value chain. The company tries to squeeze every paisa, that company achieves the cost leadership position in the industry. Now I'll tell you that, you know, we have to basically focus on what? We have to focus on the cost drivers. What are the cost drivers? And when trying to, now we can achieve the cost leadership in the following ways. First of all, the forecasting has to be done prudently. We need to have a very accurate and precise forecasting. So accurate and precise forecasting is important. Then higher level of capacity utilization is important. Now operational efficiency. When we talk about capacity utilization, we are talking about operational efficiency. So the, you know, this the operational efficiency has to be achieved and the capacity has to utilize to a higher extent. Capacity has to be utilized to a higher extent. That is important. Then the company should get the benefit of economies of scale. Now when fixed cost gets distributed over a large number of products, then cost per unit comes down, and that is the economies of scale. Then after that, the products are highly standardized. In the case when the products are highly standardized, and the service packages are also standardized. Now these 3 points we have taken. From here we will proceed in the next class. Thank you. You can reinforce these concepts from Azhar Kazmi. All these things are there in the Azhar Kazmi. Fine. Thank you.